to Tuesday with Michelle and Outlay, but great. I apologize for not being here yesterday. I got completely sidetracked, I have to be honest. I didn't teach my normal lessons yesterday, then I had to play in a concert, and my whole day was completely thrown off, and I woke up this morning and I went, wait a minute, yesterday was Monday. Uh-oh, I think I just thought it was Sunday because I wasn't teaching. I don't know. I'm just sorry I wasn't here, but I'm here now, and I think Jason gave me his day because he said he was going to be here later in the week, so we're going to have different days for a couple of us, so I do apologize for not being here. Okay, so Jim from Georgia gave us our topic this week, and I love this topic because it's very close to home for me. He asks, are there health benefits of coming out of the closet? Yes, there are absolutely health benefits. If you come out of the closet, you are no longer hiding who you are. You're no longer lying. You're no longer unhappy. Harvard researchers, I mean, we're talking top of the line medical communities, have proven in study after study after study that if you have a more positive well-being and you are happy, you are definitely healthier. And it's not just happy people don't get heart attacks. It's not like that. It's that if you are happy, then you are generally motivated to eat better, to exercise, to take care of yourself, to have the proper amount of sleep and all this stuff. Now, it's all fine and good when Harvard does a study and we go, yeah, we read it, blah, blah, blah. But I am living proof that this is absolutely true. Over the course, all right, so before I came out, I would get sick on a regular basis, you know, at least twice a year, for sure. And since I have come out, I'm gonna have to knock wood on the piano, I've only been sick a couple times in the last 8 years. And I think it's just because I'm living my authentic life. You know, I use that word all the time, living life authentically, which means that I'm happier because I'm not hiding who I am. And I'm just, I'm more true to myself and I'm more honest with who I am, honest with myself. And I took pretty good care of myself, you know, before. I mean, I worked out, I lifted weights, all this stuff. And my eating habits have only changed just slightly, but that's just in the last couple of years. I went from vegetarian to vegan. And so the only thing that makes sense of why I'm so much healthier is because I'm happier. Now, that's not to say that I was miserable for my whole life, and my ex and I, we had a really good life together. And we were always laughing and joking around, and it was a great person. He was a great person. But I was always having this inner turmoil going on, because at that time I identified with bi, because it was the only thing that made sense. It was the only thing that I could use and still be married. And so I used that term for a really long time. And it turns out that I really was a lot less bi than I thought. And that I was just, like I said, just using that word because it was the only word that I could use and as an identifier that would still allow me to be married until I couldn't do it any longer. And, you know, many of you know my whole story. I've said it like a gazillion times, but I'll say it a gazillion and one because there's new people here that might be seeing this for the first time today. In January of 2008, I became really, really sick and lost my voice. I lost work because I couldn't sing. Doctors didn't have any clue what was wrong with me. They tried to give me steroids. It's a bunch of compiled stuff that was going on. I was having I don't remember what it's called now. It's been so long since I've thought about it. You know, not heartburn, but acid reflux. And I think that was all emotionally based because I always had this kind of inner turmoil that was going on. And it had nothing to do with my ex. It didn't have anything to do with my life in general because I'm kind of doing the same things that I were before. I was before. And so the only thing I can attribute the health to is that I'm happier. I'm living an authentic life. I am finally being 100% true to myself. And so I have a lot less stress. I don't have that inner turmoil at all anymore. And knock wood, just a couple times in 8 years. So I'm living proof that coming out of the closet makes you healthier. I'm recording a little blurb here because I got upstairs after I recorded my video and I'm editing and realized that I forgot a very important part of what I wanted to say. So you guys have probably seen this before. I've pulled this off of the shelf a few times. Louise Hay, You Can Heal Your Life. And when I was really sick, a dear friend of mine who will just like, she helped change my whole life, seriously, said to me, because I lost my voice, couldn't sing, she says, "Is there something that you need to say?" And she told me about this book, and it just blew my mind. So when you go under sore throat, the part that's correlating to, in Louise Hay's mind, of why you have throat problems all the time, it says, holding in angry words or feeling unable to express the self. And that was me. That was me. I was in the closet and I needed to come out and express the fact that I was really way more than bi, that I needed to come out and live my life authentically. And then there's a little mantra that she gives you that says, "I release all restrictions and I am free to be me." Changed my life, people. Changed my life. Okay, so I'd love to hear your thoughts on this. And I will see you next week, hopefully at my usual time. And have a great week.